the Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System, with its operational name NavIC, is an autonomous regional satellite navigation system. It provides accurate real-time positioning and timing services of India and neighboring regions. It covers not only India, but many other neighboring countries.
Hello everyone, welcome back to today's topic of the day. Today, we'll be talking about the navigation with the Indian Constellation NavIC. To promote the use of navigation with the Indian Constellation NavIC, the Indian Space Research Organization will introduce the L1 frequency in all its future satellites. Now, what exactly is ISRO doing? The next satellites, starting from NVS-01 onwards, will have an L1 band from civilian navigational use. Currently, NavIC is only compatible with the L5 and S bands and hasn't easily penetrated into the civilian sector. The L1 is the oldest and the most established GPS signals, which even the less sophisticated civilian use devices such as smartphones are capable of receiving. Radio frequency communication refers to the wireless communication through the air with the electromagnetic wave frequencies ranging from 3 kHz to 300 GHz. L1 frequency is the most commonly used frequency in GPS. Now, what is NavIC? NavIC, or navigation with the Indian Constellation, is an independent standalone navigation satellite system developed by the ISRO. NavIC was erstwhile known as the Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System. NavIC was originally approved in 2006 at a cost of $174 million and became operational in 2018. NavIC consists of 7 satellites and covers the whole of India's landmass and up to the 1500 km, that is 930 miles from its boundaries. 3 satellites of the constellation are placed in the geostationary orbit and 4 satellites are placed in the inclined geosynchronous orbit. Now let's see the uses of NavIC. It is being used in the public vehicle tracking in India for providing emergency warning alerts to fishermen venturing into the deep sea where there is no terrestrial network connectivity, and for tracking and providing information related to natural disasters. Now why is India promoting NavIC? NavIC is an indigenous positioning system that is under Indian control. Removing dependence on foreign satellite systems for navigation service requirements, particularly for strategic sectors. There is no risk of service being withdrawn or denied in a given situation. Now let's see how does NavIC compares with GPS or others. GPS of US caters to users across the globe and its satellite circle in the earth twice a day, while NavIC is currently for use in India and adjacent areas. Like GPS, there are 3 more navigation systems that have global coverage. That is Galileo from European Union, Russian-owned GLONASS and China's BIDO. QZSS, that is Quasi-Zenit Satellite System, operated by Japan, is another regional navigation system covering the Asia-Oceanic region with a focus on Japan. India's 2021 Satellite Navigation Draft Policy will work towards expanding the coverage from regional to global to ensure availability of NavIC signals in any part of the world. Now, this was little bit about NavIC. Now, let's take a practice question from this topic. With reference to the Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System, consider the following statements. Statement 1. The IRNSS has 3 satellites in geostationary and 4 satellites in geosynchronous orbits. Statement 2. Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System covers entire India and about 5500 square kilometer beyond its borders. Which of the statements given above are correct? You may take a moment and give your answer in the comment section below. The correct answer is A. That is, only the statement 1 is correct. Statement 2 is incorrect. Statement 2 is incorrect, as NavIC consists of 7 satellites and covers the whole of India's landmass and up to 1500 kilometers from its boundaries. Now, statement 2 is incorrect, as IRNSS covers entire India and about 1500 kilometers, that is 930 miles from its boundaries. I hope you liked this session and found the information useful. You may also check out our daily current affairs section on our website, and for more such videos, stay tuned to NEXT IAS YouTube channel. Yeah.